Hello and welcome back to Thalric Plays Blood Bowl 2. Today we're going to play another match with our Skaven team because after our abysmal performance last match where we managed to pull out a draw in the end, I want to redeem myself. So our team value is up again because our two missing players, one Storm Vermin and of course our Red Ogre, are back in action. So let's look for an opponent, and hopefully we can do better than last time. And it looks like we're playing against a Lizardmen team. Okay, so we are getting inducements, so what should we get? That's the big question. So Lizardmen with 1360, so they are probably pretty bash heavy, so we will play it safe this time and we will get a Babe and an extra Apothecary. The wizard worked out okay in the last match, but we still had to deal with numerous casualties and KOs, so this time we're going to take it a bit safer and hopefully can make that work somehow. Of course we would prefer not getting any injuries or KOs at all, but against a team like Lizardmen that outbash us with their strength alone, it's not looking that likely, so we'll better be prepared for that. And it's the first time I think that we are experiencing rain, so that's nice, or maybe not, we'll have to wait and see. So our opponent this time is Roll Jordan with his team Sarkos. I'm assuming it is pronounced, or Sarkos. I don't know. So what does the coin flip decide? Our opponent is choosing, as most of the time. And we will set up our players in defense. Okay. So he is receiving the ball, so I need to remind myself of that, as I did make that stupid mistake last time that I didn't set up properly, and I don't want to repeat that if we can avoid it. So we have to deal with skinks, which are very fast and not easy to deal with. So what are our options here? I think this should probably work, or might work. Let me think a moment if I want to do something. Yes, we don't want Carl to be on the front there. And I'm not putting Chuckles on the line since he would just get blocked, and we do want to keep him away from there. Let me just set up like I usually do. So it is likely that he will be able to block our line of scrimmage completely, but that's okay. And he can run his skinks through the middle after that, but let's wait and see if he manages to do so. And let's check out his players. So he's got the standard roster, which is the Croxigore with no skill yet, and 6 Sauruses, and the rest are skinks. So we've got block, Nothing. Dodge, okay. Another Blocksaurus and another Blocksaurus. Okay, so three with block and one with dodge. What do his skinks have? Sidestep, block, sidestep, and nothing. Does he have reserve players? He has got one skink without a skill as a reserve player. Okay, so he does can retain one injury without being too worried. So he has an advantage there. But let's see what he does. So he's got three rerolls and the apothecary. I'm predicting that this won't be an easy match. I always struggle with Lizardmen, which is part of the reason I play them myself now, so that I get to understand them a bit better. And hopefully we can make that knowledge work for us. And we get an extra reroll, which is pretty cool. So, rain does decrease the pass chances. I'm not sure if it makes the pickup any more difficult. And then we can look at the effect of pouring rain. And so the ball is more difficult to catch, intercept, or pick up. Okay, so we can hope that his skinks won't be able to pick up the ball in the first round. That, of course, would be extremely lucky. And let's see if that will happen. Okay, so that's only a stun. We got lucky there. And he's going directly after our movement allowance Tengata runner. I should have put him here and kept him more safe, and he manages that. And he gets injured immediately, but only badly hurt. As much as I want to use the apothecary to negate that effect, I won't. That was not that smart of me. So once more, only myself to blame for that. I should have put him here and keep our gutter runner without any SPP on the sidelines. So apparently I need to keep I need to pay a lot more attention while setting up still. So this time we did set up in the right way, but our players were out of position a bit. And he fumbles the pickup. Does he use a reroll? He does not, which is the right choice, I think. The ball is very far back, so even though I'm trying to reach it, I can't. Of course, I will put him put some pressure on him and try to make our offensive work. So, what do we want to do now? We have pressure on the ball in theory with our gutter runner, and we want to get these Sauruses away. So I am going to blitz with Chuckles, and hopefully he can do that pretty well. And of course, it's a wild animal roll, so we won't reroll that. And what will we do? We will put Carl over here. And then we will dodge with Ratastic. that worked. After we are also putting Cackle back here so he can't reach him. Okay, and then we'll end our turn. Maybe, yeah, let's keep him there. So not a perfect first turn, though wild animal screwed us pretty bad. But of course he still needs to pick up the ball. And he has to blitz defensively to keep us away from the ball in case he doesn't manage to do so again. And the both down is enough, unfortunately. The big question is, will he use one of his skinks to foul us? Or will he not? Okay, he's doing an unnecessary going for it, in my opinion. So it's not unnecessary, but it was risky for the for where we are turn. He still has a lot of other important actions to do first. Okay, nice, so he's got a bonehead, which of course means his Croxigore loses all of its tackle zones and won't help him or assist him. He doesn't need the assist, but it's still a nice added bonus nonetheless. And he doesn't follow us because he don't want to be next to our red ogre, and he needs to reroll that, which he does, so he's only got two rerolls left. And that's exactly the reason I left our lineman there, even though he's getting stunned now. We force blocks on his Sauruses without any skills, so in case they fail their block, we benefit from it, because he has to use a reroll or get the turnover. So let's see, he'll probably pick up the ball again now. Let's see what he does with this Saurus, if he decides to move first. Okay, so he's thinking about binding up our Storm Vermin, and he does so. And he fails the pickup again. Okay. So that is what we wanted, pretty much. And now we will try our best to do some Skaven stuff. First, I want to block here to get Ratastic free. Might not be the smartest first move, but it's reasonably safe, and it worked. And it also opens the possibility of a surf soon, maybe. After that, I want a chance at the skink. I need a defender down to make this one work because it's got block, but it's still a good opportunity, I think. And unfortunately we did fail that, so we will push him there, and we won't follow, unfortunately. So what is our next good move? We will put Carl over here and keep another one of his skinks locked up. And then, even though it's risky, we will move Chuckles over here. We want to keep him free, but we need to keep this line in sight, so that we don't know where he wants to go on his offensive, so it won't be very easy. We still have our blitz, don't we? Okay, so I botched that one a little bit. But maybe not, so let's do this and this, and then we will blitz here. So it's a lot of dodges, but we have agility 4 and dodge, so it is still likely to work. And because of horns, we get 2 dice, and the push is all we need. So now there are no tackle zones on the ball, And I followed up here because we still haven't used up our dodge reroll, so it's better than doing two going for it. So it's a dodge and a going for it and a pickup, and we will try that. And we will reroll that. We need 3 plus. Please work. And that did work, so perfect. That was pretty awesome. We got extremely lucky that he didn't pick up the ball there and were able to do all those dodges. But it might not stay this way. That's one of the problems the Lizardmen have as well. Although the Skinks are pretty good, they also can't handle the ball very well. They don't have any skills to handle the ball very well. So the weather is making it very difficult for him to actually do anything. So now we are changing our setup here because we are missing a player. So I think what I want to do here is put him over there. I do like setting up symmetrical, but we can't. And I still don't want to put Chuckles on the line of sight, because we do want to keep his frenzy out of tackle zones so that we can possibly put pressure with a serve on him or something like that. So we'll set up this way. He doesn't have frenzy, so he can serve us. And he'll probably try to go this way because there is no red ogre there and only one storm vermin. So let's see if I'm correct with that. And we're kicking again. And we get changing weather, so it's very sunny now. And that means that there's a minus one modifier to passing rolls, which might come into effect, maybe. It's a lot more situational than the pouring rain, which modified a lot of stuff. And he has to take another reroll here, which is good for us. So he only has one reroll left and we are only in turn 3. But his armor rolls have been pretty solid so far. I think, so he's got the injury on the first block and 2 stuns. Considering the amount of blocks he did get so far, which were not that many, that's pretty solid. So hopefully that won't continue like that, or we will keep getting injuries. So getting that second Aporic to carry probably was a good idea in the end. So let's see if he can make all of his blocks work or if he will fail another one. Getting dodge on a Saurus is pretty awesome, in my opinion, because it does work together with Break Tackle, which Sauruses should get. And Misfortune is KO'd, so that happens, but we do have one Babe, so he's more likely to come back in the next drive. Of course. So he's thinking long term, which is pretty much what I'm saying. So he's probably going to go dodge, then block or break tackle, but probably these two skills will be the next ones. And he's setting up a serve here, and we won't... Oh no, he's not setting up a serve. I don't really know why. Ah, okay, he wants to keep our players occupied here so that we can't concentrate our forces on going over here. And if he keeps that player there, that is a mistake, because we will serve him if we can. We will try, at least. We might fail, but who knows. And he manages to pick up the ball, so good for him. Okay, nice. So if he wants to change sides, it means he can't advance down the pitch very far. So we will put pressure on him here so that he's forced to go over here. And let's see if that works. First we'll do this block, which is only a push, but that's okay. I just want to free up our two players here again. And after that we will try to do the red ogre bullshit. So Blitz and Frenzy. Hopefully we won't get Wild Animal again. That would be very unfortunate. Now the only thing we need is two pushes, which we don't get. We get a defender down, which works as well, but is not what we wanted. But of course, we will try to force a turnover on him. So we move our Red Ogre next to his Skinks. And the Red Ogre, of course, has Prehensile Tail, so he can't just dodge away there. Unfortunately, we can't really... We could mark him up, but I want to keep our Red Ogre free. Our Storm Vermin, Retastic here free. So I'll keep him where he is, probably. And then we'll use our our Gutter Runners, because we don't have any choice, as defense. So we will put him here and Kaka we will put here. So let's see how that works out. Our Red Ogre is also our best weapon against his Sauruses, because he is stronger than them. And he does have Mighty Blow, so he's more likely to actually injure them. And it looks like he's going to Blitz here, probably. That was a pretty risky move. He did his first block with the Croxigore, which isn't advisable. I've gone into that in a lot of detail already, because he's a loner and a big guy. So it's always risky to do the big guy loner stuff first if you don't need to. But it worked out for him, so it's fine, I guess. But he does give us an opportunity to blitz his ball carrier. And with a lucky roll of the dice, we will get the ball. Of course, that does mean putting our players on next to his Sauruses, but that's a risk I'm willing to take to get a chance at getting the ball free. So that's pretty nice of him. He did a very good job with the cage here, I think. It's pretty nice. But this player still remains a problem for him. And that's a stun. Unfortunately, we were forced to put Carl there to get the two dice for the surf last turn. And that's always the risk you have to be willing to take when putting your players next to the Sauruses. There's just nothing we could do about that, so that's something we just have to accept. And now he's doing pretty much the same thing to us. He's putting his squishy players next to us to keep us from actually moving. He could have gotten there a lot quicker if he just went around here. And the prehensile tail didn't work there. It doesn't work again, so his dodges were pretty good. But if we actually get to do what we want and succeed, we will, as a last action, try to serve the Saurus, only as a last action, as the Saurus has block, and doing stuff to him will be extremely dangerous. So let's do the more or less important stuff first. So we will block here. On the off chance that we actually can make that work, unfortunately we can't. And let's push and not follow. We need him to stay mobile. Blitzing here would be one dice. We do need the assist here. So, unfortunately, I do think our best bet is to put Laughter next to him, because he's got dodge and is less likely to be blocked away next turn. And then we will blitz and hopefully get a defender down, which we don't. I will reroll that. And now it's even worse, but he still loses the ball. So it's a turnover for us, which is not good. I should have moved Retastic over here first, but I didn't, so we'll have to adjust. He still has to pick up the ball again, which might fail. And that's good. He only managed to push us here, but I'm thinking he might blitz us. But let's see where he actually wants to go. This time his Croxigore isn't doing him a favor, so he's only pushing. Yeah, he'll probably try to break through the middle here. It's his best bet. Or he could go around this side, which would work as well by now. But we still have two gutter runners here, one with horns, and we get another KO. So now we are down three players at the moment, which doesn't make things easier. But we're still doing an okay job, I think. And let's see what happens here. It's another armor break and another stun. So luckily no injury there. We do need our gutter runners to make this work. Yeah, please do that. He's doing a dodge. I'm assuming that was a misclick. So I'm not sure if we should try to do what I want to do. But I'm assuming let's see what is our best option here. Okay, so let's do this first. And the problem I'm having is that we need to get this player away there. But I do want to blitz with our blocker, with our Storm Vermin, but I can't. So we need to take the risk and do this. I am going for the ball again. And let's see if we can make that work. So we will push him there and follow. So now we will do this, which is of course taking up a lot of roads, but it still might work. And we fumble that, but I'm willing to take that reroll. We only need a 3 plus, and it's a 1. So that didn't work out as good as well as I liked, but it's okay. We still have a player on the ball. He doesn't. He does. He has the Saurus, of course. But we blocked him here pretty well. Where will he push us? Okay, so he's pushing us onto his Croxigore, which is the correct move. Well, it does give us an easier dodge here, but it also means prehensile tail, so it doesn't matter that much. And I'm still reluctant to just go for the surf as a first action, because it might just fail and going after the ball is so much more important. But we might not get the chance to, so let's see what happens here. And he KO'd Laughter. So that's another gutter runner off the pitch at the moment. Hopefully he will come back. So let's hope that the babe will work for us. And for everyone who doesn't know the inducements that well, Bloodweiser Babe is the cheapest inducement you can get, costs 50,000. You can get two of them, and everyone gives you a plus one bonus to the KO roll to get your player back after a touchdown or after each half. So I think you usually need a 4+, so with one babe that becomes a 3+ roll, which is of course better. But because he did KO our gutter runner, we now have no real option to get to the ball anymore. Because our only other gutter runner is over here and on the ground, and we can't reach that easily. So I'm interested to see if he manages to pick up the ball or what he will do next. We are by no means in an easy situation, but we are still in the lead because of his problems in the first 2-3 turns. And that pickup worked. So now he still has 2 turns left after this one to score, which is more than enough for Lizardmen. So we somehow need to stop him. And he's doing the 2 dice against block because he can afford to with his block. And he only gets pushes, so we can't serve that player anymore, unfortunately. And I'm not sure what we should do now, because he's got most of our players bound up. So it will be very difficult to actually defend this one. But I do have an idea, and that is go big or go home. So we will blitz with Chuckles, because Chuckles is awesome, and Chuckles will blitz the skink, kill the skink, and then be next to this skink. Sounds like a plan. So let's put Ratastic a bit back first. Oh, one more space. We will keep Cackle on the ground for now, because we want to stand him up afterwards. And then we will try the blitz. So we've got a 3 dice against the skink, so there are... Okay, nope. And I will reroll that. And that's Lona for you. That is exactly why big guys are a big problem. Can we still injure him? No, we can't. So that's pretty unfortunate. And we can only hope that he somehow throws away his chance at the touchdown by doing unnecessary blocks first, which he does, but they work out so far. So no such luck. So what we should be focused on right now is not getting any more players injured or KO'd, so that we actually have enough players to play a solid offensive drive next half, because of course we will be receiving the ball and can get another touchdown. I'm hoping that if not all of our KOs come back, at least our gutter runner comes back. Because having only one gutter runner during the offensive can make things very hard. And Does he actually go only this far? Why? He will be forced to hand off the ball, I think, to get the touchdown. And because of... Okay, no, so it's passing routes, it's not catching routes, and handoff is a catch. So it doesn't affect that, but still, it's risky. He could have gotten farther down the pitch. Okay, Carl is only stunned, so lucky us, hey? And what will he do now? So he has blitzed, so all that is remaining is this one block. And that worked for him. Which is, of course, unfortunate for us. But no armor break, so it's fine. All we want to do is survive this half. And, if possible at all, keep him from scoring. Which, of course, means we will blitz this skink. And hope for a defender down. If we get to down him, it will make it a lot harder for him to get the touchdown. If it's at all possible, I'm not sure. So that's wild animal. And we will stand up here. We will leave him on the ground and not risk the possible block. So all that is left really is this blitz. And let's hope that we can get a defender down for once against a player with dodge. And we do. So he will sidestep to here or here. Okay, he goes over there, so we will just stay. And it's a stun, which is awesome. So this player can still make the touchdown. So let's do this. And also not this. Yes, this. So the touchdown is still possible for him, but we have made it significantly harder because he has to blitz one of our players here away here to for him to dodge this way or that way and get a decent dodge. He needs to hand off the ball and he needs to do at least one going for it. Because this player can't actually get the touchdown. Of course, he still has one reroll left, which is a problem, or it's not really a problem, it increases his chances of actually making it. Yeah, he pushed us in the only right space there. But he shouldn't have followed up there. So I'm interested to see if he can get that touchdown. He's doing unnecessary blocks still. And is that's very risky. So in my opinion, he should focus on the touchdown. And he isn't at the moment. Even if it is unlikely for him, if he wants to win this match, he should get the touchdown. Of course, he might go for bashing on purpose and hope to get what he is getting, which is armor breaks. I'm assuming he would like more injuries than KOs. But that's just this now. He needs to dodge to going for it and a lot of other stuff first. So it's not impossible for him to get the touchdown, but it would be very lucky. It requires a lot of successful rolls, even with the reroll he still has. So that worked, and now he will either do two going for it and a handoff, or he will try to pass. And the pass, of course, will be more difficult because of very sunny. That's 70%, that's a 6 plus. Does he get it up to a 5 plus? He does not. Will he? No, he's deciding to do this, which is probably the better choice. And he got the touchdown. So he did a lot of rolls and, in the end, got the touchdown, but he made it a lot harder on himself. Ah, I didn't see that. Okay, so two Gatoranas come back. And I need to write that one down. But we are still in the first half, so I get a chance at a one-turn touchdown, maybe. Let's see how he sets up his players. So it's nice to see another person that is interested in my videos, at least to just probably hear what I have to say about his playstyle. And let's just hope that he's happy, that you're happy if you're just watching with what I have to say, or at least can understand what I'm criticizing at the moment. There's always room to improve. I'm by no means perfect in Blood Bowl. I do make mistakes, and I already did some pretty big ones in this match, at least in the beginning, with our gutter runner here. So it's just the learning curve, and now I'm torn. Do I want to get the one-turn touchdown, or do I want to get the surf option? But I do think we have to try it just for the fun. Because one-turn touchdowns are awesome. So that, of course, requires the use of our Red Ogre again. And we will have to push a few spaces in. So it will be very difficult to get. But not impossible. And that's what I'm going for here. So we'll push him there. With the first, the second one, and we will take it from there. So let's see if we can do that. I would like to have more players to do this. It would make the later pushes a lot easier, especially against against strength 4 players. Okay, so both teams get a reroll, so get a turn, so that doesn't make things easier. I still want to do it, so let's just do it. And we will blitz here, and we need a push. And we don't get that push, so bye-bye goes the one turn touchdown. Oh no, he's got dodge. Okay, awesome. So that's still not enough, unfortunately. Can we get him? We need to put him one space further down the pitch. But we can't do that, unfortunately. As much as I would like to. Oh, that's really unfortunate. So we need to do, we still have one extra turn, so we might still get it, and he can't. So let's still try to give it our best shot. So we will block here first. That's only pushes, but that has to be enough. Then we will follow here. The problem we face now is that we have to go through one tackle zone and also have to deal with prehensile tails, so dodging there will be difficult, to say the least. So we will save that for last, and no we won't, we will do it first and pick up the ball later. Okay, that worked, and now it's a 3 plus with a reroll. And we managed to make that work as well. And now we will force him to go as far back as possible. That of course means it will be more difficult for us to get the ball where we want it to be. But let's worry about that in the next turn. And let's go to here. And let's see what he does with that. I'm really looking forward to the first time we actually get the one-turn touchdown, because it's awesome. And we are building, of course, our player for it. And if Hysteria wouldn't have been injured, we might have been able to get it, because that one space push would have been enough. But unfortunately, we didn't, so we can look forward to that for another day. And is he blitzing here or is he blitzing there? That's the big question. And he is blitzing here. I'm not sure I agree with that. It's both not a bad idea. The problem with the gutter runner is he has dodge, but he would get a reliable 3 dice block. Here he has to do two going for it, but it's a player without dodge or block. So it's likely more likely to work. So that's what we wanted. That's still by no means a touchdown yet, but we still have the chance. And that's the important part. Problem is, we can't get a solid roll here, and he's putting his Croxigor next to our ball carrier, which will make things even more difficult. But I think that just calls for another Red Ogre spectacular action, which hopefully we can make work. It will be pretty difficult to pull off, I think. But let's just see what happens. Putting the Saurus here would have been enough to get the tackle zones there, so that was an unnecessary risk for him to take. And I still can dodge through here with only one tackle zone. But he is putting his other Saurus there. So far all of his going for it are working for him. Which is, of course, unfortunate for us. And looks like he wants to do the one dice block here. With a block skink, it's reasonable. And I do hope he won't follow, but he will. Too bad, I would have liked to get that line rat. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the blitz. So we can dodge here, but because of prehensile tail, it will be very difficult to do so. And the only option we have to get him out of there, our ball carrier, is to get a chain push going. And that will be difficult to actually achieve, because we need to go around here and do a going for it, two going for its, possibly, because of frenzy. And wild animal ruins it for us, so nothing for us, apparently, which is unfortunate, but it's still okay. It's just as what it is. It's a got a red ogre that doesn't want to do anything, so there's nothing we can do about that. Do I want to dodge there? I probably don't want to risk that, so we will do this. And do we want to do a one dice? No, we don't, so we will risk the dodge here, and that didn't work. And so it's a turnover. That's still fine. It's 1-1 at halftime, and we will be attacking now. And hopefully our two remaining KO players will come back. That would increase our chances greatly, and they do. So that's good. And now he's setting up his players in defense. Okay, so I want to stay away from his Croxigore, naturally. So what I'm going to do is set up a bit lopsided, I think. And hopefully that will help with that. So let's also put our Storm Vermin next to this one. Is it the one with dodge? Yes, so let's switch sides. I don't want to deal with his dodge player. And that will make it easier for us to get to the ball, to get down the pitch, at least to block him, which is what I want to do. So we will put Retastrophe over here, because we never know where the kick is gonna end up. And we want to score with Cackle if possible, because he needs the SPP more than Laughter does, at least if we want even team development. So I think that setup is fine. So we are going to confirm. And we get another extra reroll, as we did at the beginning of the first match. Okay, awesome. So what I want to do first is do this block. And that's good enough. And we are already going into dangerous territory, because we're going to blitz with our red ogre once more to get the surf, which we don't, and it's Loner once more. So this time, this match I should say, our Loner is really screwing us over. The surf chance is just very tempting, so I choose to go for it, and he still is our best chance to actually block away players, but of course it's still very risky. And in hindsight, we might have going over here might have been the better choice, because this Saurus didn't have or doesn't have block, so that both down would have hit him too. And either way, we should have secured the ball, so we should have put Retastrophe next to the ball. But of course we didn't, and we should have put Laughter there as well. And now he can reach the ball with his skinks, and I can just hope that he won't or will fail the pickup. So that was a pretty big misplay, and well, it wasn't really a misplay, it was a risk that backfired pretty drastically. So let's see what he does with this opportunity. He's deciding to go for the pickup right away, and he actually manages to get it, which is a big problem for us. Will he actually do these? And they work as well again. So far his going for it roads have been extremely solid. But that of course means we do get an automatic blitz onto his ball carrier with our Storm Vermin. And he finally paid for his going for it with that one. So he was forced to take a reroll. And so far we would get a two dice. Will he move the skink over here to make it more difficult for us or not? He will. Okay, so that was expected. But it still would have been nice if he didn't do it. Okay, so far relying on Chuckles in this match hasn't worked very well. We've gotten two wild animal roads with a blitz, and also two Loner with a reroll. So his performance is pretty much underwhelming so far. But that's something we have to deal with. And that's something we knew from the beginning. So, as always, we can only blame ourselves. So we will put him there. Of course he will lie on the ground. Wild animal that doesn't block only has a 50% chance to get back up. Then we will do this block, because we want to free up our players. Let's put him there and stay. So now we get to move them over, which is important. No, I don't want to do that. I will go here instead. And now, even though it's not the super safe move. Oh, and I fucked it up. Stupid. That's still the one dice. He needed to go over here. So that was pretty stupid. So we are forced to do this now. And hopefully we will dodge. We will. So we fixed that somewhat. So now we get the two dice again. And we get the defender down. So we will push him over there and follow as well. And let's see where that scatter goes. I won't reroll that. That's not a good scatter. But it also could be a lot worse. So we will do this. And that's it for our turn. And he rolled a bonehead with his Croxigore. I'm assuming he won't reroll that. It's his first action again with the big guy, which is risky, as I've already mentioned. And as we have seen with our red ogre on numerous occasions this match already. So the ball is pretty clumped up, he didn't reroll that, which is the right choice. Will he push? He will push us on the ball. And he will stun us as well. So where does the scatter go? The scatter goes right into our gutter runner's arms. So I'm happy with that. Because he doesn't have any free sauruses to actually blitz us, I believe. He might get one free. He needs to do a block here and then push him over there. And he blocked us there, so he's still prioritizing his other blocks before the important ones, which of course as it is working out for him, it's okay, but he still should probably do the other ones first. The chain push here would have helped him, but he's not doing the chain push, so I'm assuming he didn't see that option. But let's see what he ends up doing. He will probably blitz us with a skink, maybe. And he will, and he gets the defender down, unfortunately. And it was his block skink as well, so it was a pretty good blitz. So that option worked as well. But we got lucky again. We got the scatter on our line red, and he actually caught it. So let's see what he does with this remaining turn. Of course, we are by no means safe here, because we still... Oh god, he does a one dice with a skink on a gutter runner and gets the defender down. And of course it's an armor break. So, cheers to that. That's extremely lucky to get. So, what do I want to do now? I want to get our thrower free. So, how do we achieve that? Our line red free. So, how do we achieve that in the best way? Well, first of all, we're going to stand up our players and hope that they actually do stand up this turn. So, where can we go if we manage this? Okay, so we want our red ogre here, I think. And he does stand up. Okay, so I will do a chain push again. We will move him here and blitz there. The alternative would have been a block here and a blitz there. And this way, since we do get the defender down, we only need this push, so we can push him there. We will follow. And our armor rolls haven't been as kind. We so far haven't been able to touch one of his skinks in a meaningful way. And after that we will risk a going for it. And in our case, it fails on the very first one. So let's do that reroll. And it works this time, and I would like to risk a second one, but we need to, I think. That's the problem. We need to take that risk. And fortunately, this time it actually did work. So, I think our best option now is to block his skinks from getting to us. So we will put our last line red over there, And we also don't want to give him another possibility to block our Storm Vermin, so we will try to dodge him away. And we fail again. And we get stunned. So that's not what I wanted, but that's what we got, so it still might have been better than the alternative. He would have gotten blocks on us, and those blocks he would need to dodge. I'm hoping he will remember this time and block first. And he's immediately forced to take a reroll, which is awesome for us. So he needed to use another reroll. What I wanted to say here, I didn't want to leave him there because he would have gotten two dice or maybe three dice even if he got another assist on our Blitzer, or Storm Vermin I should say, and I didn't want to risk that. Of course he did get, and we did end up stunned because of the failed dodge, but it was still worth the risk in my opinion. So I'm interested to see what he will do now. I'm assuming he will probably try to block here and then somehow blitz us, maybe with him. But can he actually reach? He can, but it will be going... Okay, he doesn't blitz us, he's just marking the player. So he won't blitz us this turn, or he will blitz with this player and try to get our Storm Vermin and then block this way. Okay, so we've could have gotten an easier blitz with this one, and there's the turnover because he blocked first where he didn't need to, and it backfired for him this time. So of course we still need to do a dodge here. With our land rat, I want to get one of our gutter runners over there first, though. I think it's a reasonable risk to take. Anything but a double one will work. So now we will do the important stuff first, which is of course this dodge and the possibly needed reroll. But we don't need the reroll, which is perfect. So he can of course reach us, so we will take the risk of going for it. And the first one fails again. So apparently my Skaven don't want to sprint or do anything more than is somehow necessary for them. So let's do some blocks next and hope they work out better. Apparently they do not so far. Where will he decide to be pushed? I will probably go, yeah, that works as well. So we will lose our two dice here with this guy, so we will have to do it with him. And it's a push again. And we will stay. So what I want to do now is try and go after Skroxigor. It's risky to say the least, because we once again have to use our Red Auger and also put our Storm Vermin next to his to Skroxigor. And that went as well as was to be expected this time. I don't want to dodge because of Prehensile Tail, so it's still an okay turn because we did manage to get away here, but we had to use a reroll for going for it, and this was pretty much a disaster once more. So not too happy with that turn. If we manage to get the touchdown, it's still worth it because we did get a touchdown. But this time he's doing the right thing and going for the blitz on the ball carrier right away. And he gets it, so that's why I put wanted to dodge with the Stormwürmer, with the Gutter Runner first, because we need to get there fast and faster than him. And that won't be easy. Of course, his skinks are out of place, pretty much. They're all over here. Well, these aren't that much out of place, but they need to dodge to get away, and that might fail. We still have two apothecaries, so it might have been the right choice to, or it maybe would have been the right choice to actually use an apothecary on Hysteria in the first turn to keep him on the pitch and keep that one turn touchdown threat alive. But you never know that beforehand, so I still think we made the right choice there. And we, of course, could still end up needing those two apothecaries. So it's better to have the option and not need it than to don't have the option and need it, of course. So he's moving his skinks back. And our situation is problematic. And I'll probably end up doing risky stuff again. That isn't the safest thing to do, but it's fun to do. So it's not always just about playing safe, at least for me. And so I will probably try to dodge, pick up, dodge. So that won't be easy. And let's see what he does here. So far his stunty dodges are working out fine. And he's effectively blocking our Gutter Runner from reaching there, but finally one of them failed, so good for us. Let's put Retastrophe next to the Skink, because we do want to keep him occupied in case he does manage to get the ball. This Skink is the biggest threat we face right now. Then we will move our Gutter Runner into a threatening position. And now I'm a bit torn. I think we shouldn't get too offensive, so we will put Mishap back here and we'll put Carl there, so we will keep his skinks in check. We won't do this dodge here because it's riskier because of the prehensile tail, so we will do the stupid stuff first and let's see how that works. The dodge worked. Let's see if we can get the pickup. It's a 4+, so 50%. That worked as well, so we need just one more dodge. And we got it. Okay, so that was pretty lucky, but I think we deserve some luck as well. So I'm happy with that. Let's see if our KO player comes back. He does not, unfortunately. So we're still two players down. And what are our options here? And it's Stormvermin as well. So I think what I want to do is pull these in a bit and then put Chuckles in the middle, maybe, and him over there. Let's put them in one more. So, and let's put Car one back. I think that's fine. Let's check here. We've got, yeah, that looks fine. So he's got 4 turns left to score, which should be pretty doable for him. And we so it won't at least be easy. We are two players down. So we've got 9 and he's got all of his 11. And we, I think pretty much what we are hoping for is him screwing up handling the ball or doing unnecessary actions first and failing them. Of course, he still has one reroll, so he's got at least a bit of safety there. So let's see what happens. And we get another reroll, so we are back up to 2. That will help, I think. And I think you can see why I'm having trouble with the Lizardmen. They can pretty much outbash us, and if their block rolls hold up, as his have so far, he didn't have to take that much rerolls, I think, that many rerolls, I think 2 for his blocks, I think. It gets really difficult. And also, if you can't touch the skinks and remove some of them from the pitch, there's just nothing you can do, and his armor breaks have been really solid. He's been getting through our armor constantly. And that means we have to work with very few rats. And he did 3 blocks and got 3 armor breaks, one of which was a KO, so that's fantastic for him. But I think it illustrates my point very well. His blocks work most of the time, even though he's often doing blocks with players that don't have a skill that makes it safe. And his rolls work to an extent that makes it a lot more difficult for us to get anything done, because he is getting a lot of armor breaks, and that is a huge thing for him. Because we need our players to get an effective defensive going, and we just can't, because he's marking up our standing players and has the rest stunned or off the pitch. So the match is far from over. There's still a lot of things that can happen, but it won't be easy, at least if his roles keep up like that. So let's see if he manages to pick up the ball, which is the big thing. And he does. So he can get into his cage. And we will have a very hard time now. So I do think it might be actually time to test out our horns player. Maybe. It would require a lot of dodges, so I'm not happy with that, actually. So let's do this, and of course there's the wild animal, so we won't do that. And now we are in a pretty screwed situation already. So let's put strength 2 against strength 2 here. Then we will blitz with Carl, I think, here. And that's just fantastic. That is a lot better. And we will push him there and follow, I guess. No armor break for us, unfortunately. And after that, we will do this block here. So that worked out fine. We will stay. And we do have to dodge here, I think. And luckily that worked. So let's put him one over and end our turn. And will he get another armor break? He won't. Yeah, so his offensive game is pretty solid, I think. So he's putting his skink in a cage, and he is keeping my players marked up so that I can't move around as much as I would like to. He does make a few odd choices, and his prioritizing is a bit off, I think. But that's stuff that comes with experience. So he's got most of his most of the gameplay down. So from now on, I think there's just with stuff to improve upon. So he isn't making any drastic misplays or stuff like that. It's minor things that you just have to know, I guess. And if he's actually watching this, or I hope he will agree with me. So he's moving his cage over to here. Of course, him scoring will probably mean that the game will end in a draw. I'm fine with that, considering the overall performance we had today. Our red ogre got in our way a lot of times, and we did lose our best gutter runner in the very first turn, which hampered our ability a little bit. So I still think we can be happy if we end the game in a draw. Of course, I would like to get the win, but it is starting to look very unlikely that we will actually be able to pull that one out. And he does go for the one dice, and is using his last reroll to reroll that one. Okay, so that was an unnecessary risk, I think. He should have just dodged, or just stayed there to force me to dodge. But he didn't. So we do get another chance to make something work here. I'm not sure what we will make work here yet, but something. Well, first let's try and do a blitz here. And unfortunately, we do roll a double one, which is probably the worst turn that could have happened on. So now the game is pretty much a draw. He has three Sauruses plus two Skinks here that he can move at will around to form his cage, but he's going for the risky thing and doing a handoff. It works for him, so I won't say anything, but that was another thing that he shouldn't have done, even considering that he would have leveled up the skink, which is, I think, more important than getting the touchdown right away. I'm assuming he wants to try and go for the win, which is what I'm... He's giving me the opportunity as well. And I have a reroll and he doesn't, so let's see. Our 2 KO player do come back, so we are back at up to 10 players. And we both have one turn left, so I will once more attempt the one turn touchdown. And let's see if we can get it this time. 3, 6, okay, he's at the right spot. So this time we do, of course, want his dodge player to be there. Let's just put him here. Let's face it, if he gets a perfect defense, we're screwed anyway, so we can commit fully to this one, I think. So we need to put him over there, actually. And that one doesn't need to be here, so we'll push him there, and let's put our... Nope, we will put our other gutter runner back here. And then he will go here, and we will keep him back. So let's go through that, push him here, push him there, use this guy to block, and actually, yeah, that should work, I think. So we will confirm that setup. And I hope you all wish me luck. So he does get a blitz, so not good, because that gives him a very big chance to actually maybe pull out a win. And I really did not want to see that one. So that's the best we could hope for. And he's getting a stun as well. But of course, he still put skinks on our red ogre. So I can't just do what I wanted to do. And we will have to improvise. The question is, can we still make it work? And it's a big question. I think the answer is a definite maybe. So I'm going to stop talking and start thinking, so give me a moment here. Yeah, still we need to do that first, and that worked. And we finally get an armor break, but unfortunately no injury. Getting that one would have been nice for us. The problem we do face now is that we need to make a difficult dodge to get the push into here. I don't just want to go for the stupid pass and stuff, so I want to do the risky thing, because that's what makes Blood Bowl fun, at least for me. So we will do this and get our two dice and probably fail the dodge. But I still want to do it, and we've got a reroll. And we fail again, so at least we tried. It was very unlikely to actually work. Okay, so it was a 75% chance to actually get the dodge with the reroll, but if the dice don't want to, the dice don't want to. So it's a draw. I can live with that. I'm thinking he can live with that as well. We didn't use up an apothecary, so we should have used it on Hysteria in the first turn, but we could still get an injury here because he still got his last turn left. Will he get one? That's the question. He only gets a push. So I'm happy about that. And of course he still gets a few blocks, and let's see if he can get them to work. If we want to nitpick, he should have done this one first, because I've got a Storm Vermin with blocks, so this one would have been less risky. And that might very well be a problem. Luckily it isn't. Mighty Blow against armor value 7 is not nice. So just one block left. He gets that one as well. And he gets one last armor break, but it's only a stun, so no problem here. So yeah, I think all in all it was a good game. We had some problematic rolls that created a lot of problems for us, so considering that, I think we did okay. I once again made a mistake in the setup. which cost us our strongest gutter runner in the very first turn. Okay, so he won't foul on the last turn, which is just good form, I think. Okay, so that's the match. Let's see what we get in winnings. And okay, so we get a lot of winnings, which is nice. We also get a fan factor and an MVP on a line rat, which will level up because of that. So I'm happy about that. Let's do that level up real quick and see what Rack rolls. He rolls a double, which I believe means we do have to go strength and we will have to take guard. You don't get a lot of guard with Skaven, and of course that means that he will be in contact with players a lot, so he probably won't live very long or stay uninjured, but it still gives us a slight advantage, so we will go for it. And of course, having that much money means we will get our last gutter runner, but I still need to think about a name, so we will do that in our next match at the beginning. So that's it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, leave me a like or a comment, and if you want to hear more of me, just subscribe to my channel. As always, thanks for watching, and I hope you tune in next time. Bye!